Friends, welcome back again. As I promised, in this lecture, I am going to discuss with you the order of reaction. In previous lecture, we discussed about the molecularity of the reaction, and by this lecture, you are going to get clear-cut idea about the differences between order and the molecularity of the reaction. To understand the order of reaction, we have to consider a hypothetical reaction. Let us consider reaction of reactant A giving product B. We have considered the reaction of reactant A giving the product P. Friends, as this reaction is progressing towards the product, what is going to happen? Initially, the concentration of reactant A will be higher, and as reaction proceeds toward the product formation, the concentration of reactant A goes on decreasing and the concentration of product goes on increasing. So this is the trend of reaction. Concentration of reactant decreases and concentration of product increases. The rate of the reaction can be written like this. Rate is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. How the rate law equation is written? Rate is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant A to the power x. We'll see what is exactly this power x. This equation then written as rate is equal to constant concentration of reactant A to the power x. This equation is written as rate is equal to constant into the concentration of reactant A to the power x. And then this constant is nothing but small k. And friends, I'm very happy to tell you that this small k is known as rate constant. I am not here to discuss what is exactly rate constant. I am here to discuss the order of reaction. So we will not go in detail about the rate constant. So again, I am repeating, friends. So reaction of reactant A to the product P has a rate equation. Rate directly proportional to the concentration of reactant A to the power x. So rate law equation, rate is equal to constant into the concentration of reactant A to the power x, and this constant is rate constant. So at the end, we have got the equation like this. For this reaction, we have obtained the equation, rate is equal to rate constant into the concentration of reactant to the power x. Now, friends, this power which is written here, this power is called as order of reaction. The power x is called as order of reaction. The definition of order of reaction is the sum of the powers. Here summation is not there, as reactant is only one. If reactants are more than one, the definition becomes like this: sum of the powers to which concentration of reactant is raised is known as order of reaction. To understand this order completely, we have to consider experiment. Because order of reaction is experimentally determined quantity. Let us consider a hypothetical experiment. Now, we know the equation, rate law equation is like this. Rate is equal to rate constant into the concentration of reactant A to the power x. Now, friends, as this is constant, I am not going to write it, because it will disturb us. I am writing the equation like this. Rate is equal to concentration of reactant A. This is constant. Concentration of reactant A to the power x. Now, friends, let us consider that if I increase the concentration of reactant two times. This is the concentration of reactant. If I increase it by two times. So I have written two. And assume that rate of reaction increases two times. So by increasing the concentration of reactant twice, the rate of reaction also increases two times. So equation is in front of you. So what is there? 2 is equal to 2. So can you guess what will be this power x? Right? Very, very good. So it will be 1. So rate increases 2 times when the concentration of reactant increases 2 times. So the power becomes 1. Let us consider another reaction. So we have this equation, rate is equal to rate constant, concentration of a reactant, concentration of reactant A to the power X. Friends, assume that I am increasing the concentration of reactant A 2 times and rate increases 4 times. Rate increases 4 times. What will be the value of power X? What will be the value of power X? So 4 is equal to 2. So 2 raised to, what will be the value? 2. Yes, it is right. So 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4. So the power becomes 2. So here in this case, if I increase the concentration of reactant 2 times and rate increases 4 times, the power becomes 2. Let us assume next experiment. If I increase the concentration of reactant twice and rate increases 8 times. How many times rate increases? Rate increases by 8 times. 8 times rate increases. So what will be the value of X? To get this equation, 2 is equal to 8. What will be the power X? So power will be 3. So we know 2 into 2 into 2. So 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8. So the power will be X. So if rate increases 8 times, by increasing the concentration of reactant 2 times, the power will be 3. So how this power is derived? This power is obtained by carrying out experiment. This power is derived by carrying out experiment. If the experiment gives this result, by increasing the concentration of reactant A 2 times, rate increases 2 times. If this is the experiment, the value will be 1. If it increase, by increasing the concentration of reactant A 2 times, if it increases the rate of reaction 4 times, the value will be 2. If it increases rate 8 times, the value will be 3. So how we have derived the value of order of reaction? We have derived the value of order of reaction by doing the experiment. By performing the experiment, we can know the value of order of reaction. Without experiment, the value of order cannot be determined. By looking at only at the equation, you cannot determine the order of reaction. For that, you must perform some experiment. And by knowing the value of power, by carrying out the experiment, you can know the order of reaction. So in this experiment, we perform various experiment and we determine the value of order of reaction. And this order X, depends upon the, what is the effect of concentration of the reactant on the rate of equation. So hey friends, order is 1, it is called a first order reaction. If the order is 2, it is called a second order reaction. If order is 3, it is called as third order reaction. And we have determined these quantities by carrying out the experiment. So it is said that order of the reaction is a experimental quantity. It is determined from the experiment. Let us consider another experiment to understand the concept deeply. Let us consider this equation. Let us consider this equation. A plus B giving product P. Friends, can you determine the order of reaction for this reaction? Can you write the rate law equation? You can write the rate law equation. Rate law equation is equal to rate constant, concentration of reactant A. Now reactants are 2. So you have to write concentration of reactant A to the power X and concentration of reactant B to the power 1. Now, friends, don't get confused with the coefficients. Coefficient of A is here 1. Coefficient of B is 1. It does not mean that the power of X is, power of A is 1. The power of B is 1. It does not mean that powers are 1. Always students are making mistake. They are writing the coefficients here. Coefficients are not order of reaction. We cannot write the order of reaction by looking at the chemical equation. For that you have to perform the experiment. So we have this rate law equation. Rate is equal to rate constant, concentration of A to the power X, concentration of B to the power Y. So what will be the order of reaction? Already we have discussed order is the sum of the powers to which concentration of reactants are raised. So sum of the powers means X plus Y. This becomes the order of reaction. and it is also called as overall order of reaction. So to determine the value of x and y, you have to perform the experiment. You have to perform the experiment. What is the effect of rate of, what is the effect of cons, what is the effect, sorry, what is the effect of change of concentrations of reactants on the rate of reaction. Let us see. If, friends, if I increase the concentration of reactant to A, I increase the concentration of reactant A by 2 times, rate increases 4 times. This is the experiment. Concentration of reactant A increased by 2 times, rate increases 4 times. What will be the value of the power? It will be 2. So, order with respect to reactant A is 2. So, here the value will be 2. Here the value will be 2. Am I right? Now, this is in case of reactant A. By increasing the concentration of reactant A 2 times, the rate of reaction increases 4 times. So, the power becomes 2. Order with respect to reactant A becomes 2. Let us consider the B. If I increase the concentration of reactant B 2 times, and what has happened? The concentration in rate of reaction increases 2 times. By doubling the concentration of reactant B, the rate of reaction increases 2 times. So what will be the power of B here? It will be 1, because 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2. So it is 1. So 2 plus 1, summation of the power becomes 3. So order of the reaction is 3, and this reaction is called as third order reaction. So friends, here coefficient of A is 1, but the order is not 1, order is 2. Coefficient of B is 1, but the order is but this coefficient does not mean that the order is 1. The order of B is 1. It is determined by performing the experiment, and the experiment was by doubling the concentration of B, rate was increased 2 times. So the power of B is 1, and the power of A is obtained as 2. 2 plus 1, the order of reaction is 3. So the coefficients are not order. Order is determined by performing the experiment. Let us perform another experiment to understand the concept of order of reaction deeply. Suppose this is reaction twice A plus B giving product P. So reaction is twice A plus B giving product P. So rate law equation is equal to, rate is equal to constant K, concentration of reactant A, concentration of reactant B to the power X and to the power Y. Now friends, this power X is not 2. The coefficient of A is 2. This does not mean that order is 2. Already I have discussed with you, coefficients are not order. Coefficient of B is 1. This does not mean that power of B is 1. For that, you have to perform the experiment. What is the effect of change of concentrations of reactant on the rate of reaction? Let us perform the experiment. Let us perform the experiment. Now, by doubling the concentration, I am finding the order with respect to A. By doubling the concentration of reactant A, rate increases 2 times. This is the experiment. This is the conclusion we have obtained. By doubling the concentration of reactant A, rate increases 2 times. What will be the power? Power will be 1. So order of A, order of reaction with respect to A will be 1. Order is 1. Let us go for B. Let us go for B. By doubling the concentration of B, rate increases 8 times. Rate increases 8 times. Can you guess the power? Yes, the power will be 3, because 2 raised to 3 is 8. So order with respect to reactant B is 3. So the overall order of reaction will be, overall order of reaction will be, the order with respect to A is 1. The order with respect to B is 3. So overall order is 4. So this is the fourth order reaction. So friends, see, the coefficient of A is 2, but the order is not 2. Order with respect to A is 1. Coefficient of B is 1, but the order is not 1. Order is 3. Order is 3. Coefficients are not order of reaction. And overall order is 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. So how order is determined? You can determine the order of reaction by doing the experiment, by changing the concentration. You have to see what is the effect on the rate of reaction. In this way, we can easily find out the order of reaction. Now, let us consider another reaction. A gives product P. What is the reaction? Reactant A giving the product P. Now friends, rate equation is rate is equal to rate constant concentration of reactant to the power X. Now if friends, if the experiment is like this, if I increase the concentration of reactant 3 times, and what has happened? Rate increases 9 times. So in this experiment, by tripling the rate of concentration of reactant A, rate increases 9 times. So 3 times increase the concentration of reactant A, increases the rate of reaction by 9 times. What will be the power? So 3 raised to 2 will be 9. 3 into 3 is equal to 9. So the power is 2. So order of reaction will be 2. Coefficient is 1, but the order is 2. So the order is determined by knowing the effect of concentration of reactants on the rate of reaction. So friends, in this way, we have determined order can be 1, order can be 2, order can be 3, order can be 4 also. Now, friends, if I ask you, by changing the concentration, by changing the concentration of reactant, if rate does not changes, by increasing the concentration of reactant, if rate does not changes, what will be your answer? If there is no effect on the rate of reaction, this value does not changes, so definitely the value will be zero. If there is no effect of concentration of reactants on the rate of reaction, the power will be zero. We know that anything raised to zero is one. So there is no change in the rate of reaction. One means rate will remain as it is.